Ya has echado de todo de mí. In God's great love and wisdom, He instituted the very first home. It did not originate in the heart and the mind of man, but in the heart and the mind of God. There is no human relationship that can compare with that of a husband and a wife. It is the only relationship upon this earth in which the Bible declares that you actually become one, that you are one flesh. So Alberto and Kristi, the Bible teaches your relationship is to be the closest relationship that you have. In Genesis chapter 2, God saw that it was not good for man to be alone, so He caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam. Out of his rib, God created a helpmate for Adam, brought her into him, and she was called woman because she was taken out of man. God then brought them together and made them to be one flesh. So in Genesis 2:24, Bible declares, therefore shall a man leave his father and mother and cleave unto his wife. The two shall become one flesh. In the New Testament, the book of Hebrews states, marriage is honorable among all. So as Kristi re-enters into this union with Alberto, who gives this woman to be married to this man? Okay. Well, you may be seated. Kristi and Alberto, this is your special day. You've waited for a long time, and we rejoice with you. You're surrounded by a lot of people who love you, family and friends, and so relax, enjoy the day. This is your special day. God's presence is with you. Both of you are born-again believers in Jesus Christ. It's my privilege to baptize both of you, and what a joy it is for me to officiate this today and share with you this very special day. Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verse 12 says, one can be defeated, two can defend, but a cord of three strands is not easily broken. And so, Alberto and Kristi, I would encourage you in the days to come that whenever you have God as the third strand in your life and in your relationship and your marriage, that's not easily broken. And so, as long as God is first in your marriage and your life, God is going to be there with you, strengthening you all the way through. And so that cord is not easily broken. Alberto and Kristi, you both come to this time together this afternoon, a very important time in your lives. You've chosen each other all over again as lifetime companions. And your commitment is such an important commitment that it's good to have a clear definition of love. In 1 Corinthians 13, the Apostle Paul gives us that definition whenever he says, love is patient, love is kind, it is not jealous. Love does not brag, it is not arrogant, It does not act unbecomingly. Love does not seek its own. It is not easily provoked, does not take into account a wrong that is suffered. It does not rejoice in unrighteousness, but it rejoices in the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never fails. So, Alberto and Kristi, since you're both making such an important commitment this afternoon, I want to ask you both a very important question. First, Alberto, do you promise to love, honor, and respect Kristi as your wife? Kristi, do you promise to love, honor, and respect Alberto as your husband? Before you exchange your vows, I want to remind you that marriage is a covenant. God was a covenant-making God with His people. He made a covenant with us through His Son, Jesus Christ. Remember, we have a relationship with Jesus. We have a covenant with God. And your vows today are a covenant, not only that God is hearing, but that you're making to one another. And the vows that you're about to exchange are to be shared as a bond of honor. If you keep these vows, God will make your home be a source of joy as well as a blessing to others. Alberto and Kristi have written their vows for each other. And so as a recommitment of your love, I'm going to ask you both this time to recommit your vows. First of all, Alberto, copy those of the vows that you wrote.
Kristi, have a lot to say. I think I should have a big face when I say a lot. We have too much in our story, and here's my poetry. Kristi, you stole my heart since the first time I saw you. You are my soulmate. We are perfect fit most of the time. We were meant to be together. I love you and always be. Even if I don't tell you, I can't be without you. I need you next to me. I promise to be next to you till my last day on earth. I will take care of you. I will continue to be the Romeo of your life, plan a romantic day and give you roses when I remember. And please don't get mad at me if I forget. When I'm old, I will ask someone to get flowers for me. Because by then I would probably not be able to walk. I remember the first time I saw you on the dance floor. You look so beautiful. And I told myself, I will do anything for her to be with me. I didn't know you were a roller coaster ride. And it would make me jump out of airplane, get headaches, get gray hair, and now I'm going bald. I don't want to know what's next. Just kidding. I love you for the person who you are, the one who always has been next to me, always. And now, I will have you for the rest of my life and hope you don't have to take care of me whenever I get old. Good luck with all that, if you do. I thank God for everything He has done with our life. He has decided today for you to be my everything, together for the rest of our life. I love you, Kristi, more than Max, and I love the strawberries. What's up? Love you.
Kristi, here are your vows that you wrote.
The day has finally come, and I want to thank Alberto for working so hard to make my dream come true. As we stand here in front of family and friends, I want to give our Father in Heaven all the praises for being able to renew our vows. Let's bow our head. Lord, I want to thank you for revealing what true love is and for blessing our marriage. Your countless love and grace is what keeps our marriage strong and bound together. I love you, Lord, and I give you all the glory. Amen. Alberto, in May 2014, I met with Melissa Fernandez in our yard. I talked forever with her about finding a church home, and then you came home from work and I introduced her to you. I told you she worked for the church. You greeted her and asked her if she was with the Catholic Church. She answered no, and then you proceeded to tell me in Spanish you had to use the restroom and went inside the house. I sat for a pretty long time with Melissa trying to figure out what it was I thought I needed from the church. She gave me Sunday school and service information, and we started to attend First Baptist that month. And by June 20th, 2014, Jesus saved my life. Why do I share this again with all of you here today? Well, it had a huge impact on our family, marriage, but most importantly on me. I realized at this point that the love and forgiveness Jesus had for me was one that I needed to incorporate in my marriage. I need to let the Lord heal and mend our marriage, and He did exactly that for the next few years. I soon found out with Christ on our side, our heart's desire would come to be. Ecclesiastes 4:12 says, though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken. Alberto, today I vow to continue to put God first and to grow together in Him. I will be patient and forgiving, just as Christ has forgiven us. I promise to work to love you better for the rest of our lives and to put your needs before my own. Our enduring love has prevailed in the last few years, and today, Alberto, I reaffirm my love to you. Thank you, Alberto, for loving me unconditionally.
Let's pray together. Father, I want to thank you today for Alberto and Kristi, and God, most of all, that they have come to know you as personal Savior and Lord, and they have a spiritual bond that is between them. Thank you for bringing them together. God, we thank you for how you have blessed them through the ups and downs of life that we all have. God, I just pray your blessings will continue to be upon them. Thank you for the vows that they've exchanged to one another. We have heard them, but God, most of all, you have heard them, and I just pray that you will bless them. Thank you, Father, for being committed to us the way that you do. And I just pray again your blessings upon Alberto and Kristi in the days ahead. In Jesus' name, amen. Kristi and Alberto, before you exchange your rings and share the ring pledge, I want to remind you that rings are highly symbolic. They are symbolic of the love, first of all, God has for both of you, but also the love that you have for one another. The ring is a perfect circle. It has no place of ending or place of beginning, kind of the way that God's love is for us. It symbolizes the love that's never going to end. So at this time, I would ask you to take your rings as the symbol of vows that you've taken, and we will exchange those together. Place it upon the ring finger of your left hand and repeat after me. With this ring, I commit myself and my love to you until death us do part. Kristi, I ask you to take Alberto's ring at this time. Place it upon the ring finger of his left hand. Kristi, repeat after me. With this ring, I commit myself and my love to you until death us do part. Alberto and Kristi, your wedding rings are symbolic of love, of strength, of endurance, and may you think of your love for each other each time you look at your wedding rings. Let's bow for prayer. Father, thank you again for the symbols that you give to us in life, the symbol of a ring, of never-ending love that Alberto and Kristi have pledged together today, but also a never-ending love that you have for us. And I thank you for the symbol of the cross. That's the symbol of sacrifice and the greatest love that anyone could ever have, which is your love for us. So Lord, today, would you again bless this couple, bless this family. I just pray in the days to come, Lord, as they make decisions, you'll give them wisdom, all that they do, may your hand be upon them and may your presence fill them. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. The tradition of lighting unity candles shows us the one flesh concept of Christian marriage. Two persons become one flesh, just as two testaments of God's Word, the Old and the New, come together to form one great book. Alberto and Kristi, the two smaller candles today represent your lives. Until this day, they were lit by your families. The large central candle represents your life from this day forward. You're no longer two, now you are one. And so as a symbol of your love and the vows that you've taken, the rings you've exchanged, I would ask you at this time to make your way to light the unity candle.
primer baile de marido y mujer. ¡Damas y caballeros! Señor y señor.
Thank you.
madre, hija y padre. Claro que sí, con ustedes. Ahí estamos en esta bellísima noche. Claro que sí. Por favor, si podemos dar el aviso, la presentación, la invitación a la querida madre reina de Alberto, por favor. A la señora Hilaria, de favor, los aplausos. A la querida madre, la señora Hilaria, de paz. The mother and daughter dance, Mrs. Hilaria. fuerte para la señora. Y dale de paz.
Thank you. Thank you for coming. For those who don't know me, I'm Nelson. I'm Alberto's longtime friend and best man. Okay. Oh my God. Me and Alberto have known each other for a little over 20 years. Me and him have been through a lot. From us crashing his brother's car, to us getting jumped, to us losing one of our best friends 2 years ago. All this to say that I realize how valuable childhood friendships are. We know he can count on me for anything. What I love about Kristi and Alberto is how fun they are to be around. Alberto has the funniest conversations, and Kristi just showed up one day and never left. Kind of like my life. I wish them the best, and I know tonight is another beginning to an amazing marriage. We love you all. Bye.
For anybody that doesn't know me, I'm Kristi's favorite sister. I'm also her only sister, but she swears I'm the favorite, especially when it's time to clean.
She's OCD, that's why. I'm the dirty one, sorry.
As y'all can tell, I didn't write anything down. So, this is all comes from my heart. We grew up really close together. Unfortunately, we did really bad things and stepped out of our house. And we got distant about a year ago when she lost her twins. We became close again, and I am very thankful for that. And I wish y'all the best of luck, and thank y'all everybody for coming out. I love y'all.